Alright, it's only me. I've come on this morning nice and fresh. Me and the dogs just back from the Scud Beach. We went a walk down there this morning early to try and soak up some of this storm. But it's not actually a storm yet. Maybe it'll get a bit stormy this afternoon, I don't know. But a nice bracing walk. Ken, but it's either windy doing Stevenson's show us. I mean, you were going to get that anyway, but wasn't it quite as mental as what the phone's going to be? But besides that, anyway, I better watch what I'm doing with this album cover, because what one was it I did last week? Was it the Scorpions one for Loft Drive? And the video got banned just because I'd put the album cover on it, because it's got the bit with the guy's horn attached to the woman's breast with chewing gum. The video just got flat out banned. And then there was one before that as well, the David Byron Take No Prisoners, when David Byron's on the front there with no t-shirt on, also got flagged, although that one survived, but it took a couple of days to pass the test. So Def Leppard's High and Dry album, it was the album of the day today. An absolutely hideous album cover, done by Hypnosis. Storm Thorgerson and Aubrey Powell, who did so many Pink Floyd, UFO, whoever album covers on this one, they've got it spectacularly wrong. There were some that they did that were pretty good, but there are some that they did that were pretty crap. Kind of Led Zeppelin as well. So the song I'm going to do today is the last track on the album, which is a band-burning Def Leppard song. Probably the fastest Def Leppard song I think there's ever been. A song called No No No, which I don't think is the go-to track when people think of Def Leppard's High and Dry album. They may probably may think of a Let It Go, or Bringing On The Heartbreak, or whatever, or The Rewrite at AC/DC's Highway To Hell, High and Dry Saturday Night. But me, I'm going to do this one. It's the last track on the album. It's fastest song, I'm pretty sure. I need to check the meter. But I don't think a Def Leppard ever played another song this fast. So it's a nice wee short one, but it's pretty good, pretty fast. Quite hard to keep up with at times. It starts off with this riff. It starts in C, going up to D, and then going down through B to A. Just with this, which is also the last phrase of the song as well. But then the guitar riff comes in and goes, that heavy AC/DC, Thin Lizzy, and another couple of bands you could probably put your finger on influenced in this track. Definitely AC/DC, because Mutt Lange had just finished working with AC/DC on Highway to Hell, Back in Black. And for those about the rock, he'd obviously learned a few things about recording a rock band. Because when you think of the differences between Def Leppard's On Through the Night album and High and Dry, Tom Allen produced On Through the Night, definitely a 70s rock vibe to that album. High and Dry, very much Mutt Lange bringing in what he had learned for AC/DC. There's no doubt about it. I mean, if you listen to it, just the guitar work and stuff. It just shows as well when you've got different two guitar players in the band, the total sound of the band changes. Ken, Steve Clark, Pete Willis version of Def Leppard, very much a hard rock, at times heavy metal act. So here we go, we're going to cover this riff now after doing that. In comes the guitar riff. And different for AC/DC, if this had been an AC/DC track, Cliff Williams would have just been rumbling along the bottom with it. But rather than that, on this one, Rick Savage actually plays along with the riff on here, which goes... And there's that singing in there. And then just do the riff again with it. And then the next time you do the riff, it's got the B run on it with it. And Friday's got this link up riff in there as well, sorry, in the singing, in the verses, where it goes from E to F and then up to C, down to B through A, G and back up to A, with this, before that riff comes in, so it'd be like... That kind of thing. What else do we need in here? Is there anything else? Aye, that bit in there for the chorus with the no, no, no. Very, very Thin Lizzy, kind of 70s Thin Lizzy. We just start CB. And then doing an A with a kind of octave thing happening with that. Same time. So the G, the F sharp and the D you're using there. Guitar solo just four times through the riff, and then what happens at the end? Oh, at the end chorus just does the same thing, except the last time there's a kind of gang vocal where it goes twice. With that motif that you play at the beginning there. So let's have a burn through this. This is a good one to start off a nice stormy Sunday. We have a bit of fast Def Leppard. It would never be like this heavy metal again. Pyromania, by that time Mutt Lange had brought in what he'd learned doing Foreigner 4, which was the album he made after he did Def Leppard's High and Dry, working with Mick Jones out of Foreigner. And then Pyromania's like a mix between AC/DC and Foreigner, if you'd ever listened to it. So anyway, let's go. Try and jump on at the start here, because it's quite awkward trying to jump, remember where you jump into this. It starts off with like this echoey guitar thing. So here we go, this is Def Leppard's No No No. Start that again, because that just ruined it. Then you miss the step. Here we go again. how you play the Def Leppard song, No, 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 which is really, really negative. Whoever wrote the best song called No, No, No? Who knows? Kiss, what, Dud One, who else? There's a few. Anyway, I can't be bothered thinking about that, you know. So anyway, that's how you play a bit of heavy metal Def Leppard. Hey, I'm out of here, man. I've got stuff today. Thank you very much for watching. Have a nice Sunday. And keep listening to Early Def Leppard.